Food and workouts and everything like that.
The living works in my life because I don't want others to miss heaven.
Some of us don't really know him, and we barely experienced God pay a bill in our life. And so we're like, I don't know with him like they know him. But his will is for all of us to know him that way. That I will do anything for you. And as a matter of fact, I love you so much, I've already done it. Did you hear what I said? He's already done it. And when you experience that in your life and you know him, you have a reverence for him like none other. And he is waiting to give you wisdom, but only those who say, I revere you so much, I'm going to sit at your feet. And whatever it is you got to say, I'm going to sit down in my life and I'm going to let you minister to me. I'm going to submit, I'm going to be humble, and I am going to sit here in humility and receive from you. That's the person who can now receive from him and then will walk in the wisdom. But those who are standing up in their lives, metaphorically speaking, they still can't get no wisdom. Why? Because I am still the source of all that I know. I am the one who has experienced this and that and this and that and this and that, and I had to work my way out of this and work my way out of that and figure my way out of this and figure my way out of that. And so God is, he's real, he's there, but you're still the one fixing all your situations and problems, so you don't know him like that. So all that you know to do is only based on what you have experienced. I'm telling you, child of God, God has something greater than that. Your life can be lived by his hand and not by your experience. There's stuff that you are headed towards that you ain't gonna know what to do with it, but he will guide you right around it or through it or over it. There is nothing that can stop a believer who fears the Lord. That one song you used to sing in children's ministry, I can run through a troop and leap over a wall. That whole thing is about God's power working in my life. No matter what the obstacle, no matter the situation, when I know him and I fear him and I walk with him, he will enable me to do whatever needs to be done. The Bible is full of stories of people who heard God, listened to him, and obeyed him. And you will only be able to do that and walk in that type of wisdom if you fear him. And so to do the opposite would be foolish. Are you seeing that now? To negate all of that wisdom, to negate all of that love, to negate all of that grace, is to really not know him. And if you're not in the knowing him, loving him, fearing him, walking with him camp, then you're in the foolish camp. And today I want you to make sure you switch camps, or that you get your other foot fully out of the other one. Because some of us, we fear him in some parts of our lives, but not in others, and you're just like this. And anybody like that is easy pickings for the devil. Because you can't go nowhere. You're trying to be with him and not be with him. You need to be with God with everything. You need to trust him with everything. You need to know that his hand is real and operating in your life with everything concerning your life. If you agree with that, say amen. Now, I would be remiss not to show you that last word in verse 7. Go to the next page. It says, but fools despise wisdom and what? Discipline. Correction. Discipling. Helping you go the right way for success in your life. We were talking about in our leadership meeting earlier that sometimes, especially in the body of Christ, you know, we have a problem with just being told what to do. Nobody gonna control me. Nobody want to control you. We're trying to help you walk on the path that God has set for your life. None of us should be manipulated. Amen. Amen. But instruction is not always manipulation.
Thank you so much for watching The Root Network with us on today. We're so glad to be able to share how to be fruitful from the root to the fruit in every area of your life. Make sure that you like this, that you share this, that you subscribe to this so that you can continue to help us spread this gospel of grace and this ability to be fruitful all over the world. Again, remember, you're victorious, and we thank God for you. We'll see you next time on The Root Network.